Hello everyone and welcome to this webinar on Synergita product updates. I'm Manali Vyas, your host today. Today we have a speaker as Nagarjun. He's the senior analyst at Synergita. He's a product specialist here and he'll be sharing his experience and he'll be sharing the latest updates with you in this webinar today. Meanwhile, if you guys have any question at the end of the session, you please type them in the chat window and send it to us. We'll be ready to answer them. And now I would like to hand over the control to Naga and he'll take forward from here.
Good evening all, this is Nagarjun from Synergita implementation. Thanks for choosing Synergita. In today's webinar, I will walk you through about the Synergita product updates. And we're gonna cover the topics like new import utility, UI updates, new enhanced reports, mobile app enhancement, and other features. So first we will see one by one. So first we can share about the new import utility. So now the new import utility has been done in three import facilities for employee data, employee relationship data, and the employee goals. So this import facility can be done in simple three steps. So let me show you that one by one. So first we can see about the employee data import utility. So it is a three steps process to do the import. So first you have to download the template and then populate the necessary data into the Excel file and then validate the imported data and upload the imported data. So once the validation is done, so you will be getting the status, so where you can see the valid records and invalid records. So the same can be downloaded as an Excel file and then you can do the corrections. So now the new employee data import utility as a new functionality that will help single field data update as well. For example, if you have 100 employees designation to be changed, so now this feature will enable you to do only one field update as well, instead of doing all the basic details updating. So let us see the pictorial representation of the new import data. So here you can see the step one where you can download the template and then you have to populate the necessary information based on the guidelines provided in the step one. So then if you have the data ready for the update, then go to the second step where you can see the import and validate option. So where you can choose the file and do the validation. So the system will provide the validation status. So based on that, you can move to the step three. So where you can see three options available for you. So if you are updating the records, which is existing employees, then you have to choose the update only option. For example, if you're updating for a new employee, then we have to choose the create only option. If you have both existing employees as well as the new employees to be updated, then you have to choose create and update icon. And then you have to start the process for importing. So once this is done, the data will be get uploaded into the system. So next we can move to the employee relationship import utility, which is similar to the employee data information. Similarly, we have three steps process. So here you can download the template and then do the validation. And then you have to upload the information in the third step. So next we can see about the employee goals import utility. So this is also a three steps process. So this is a new functionality which is introduced in this product. So where employee goals can be inputted through import by three steps. So here you will have the review period. You have to choose the respective review period for selecting the goals for the employee. So we have to choose that and then download the template and then add the necessary goals for the employee and then save the file. And then you have to do the step two where you have to import the validation. So where you will have the option to select the status as approved and then import the file. Once the files are validated, it will show the error status. If you have any mistake in that, then you have to do the correction, and based on that, you can re-upload the file for the upload. So once this is done, the employee goals will be set in the system. So these are the some of the features that we have recently introduced in the Go import utility in the system now. So next we can see about the UI updates. So now we have improved our UX enhancement in the dashboard page, my team page, my team performance page, and my team training pages. So these new updates will provide the benefits of modern look and more readability for the users and the better experience as well. So these are the some of the enhancements which we have done in the new look dashboard, in the my team performance page, and the my team training pages. So this new field will provide more clarity and the modern look. So next we have enhanced reports. So first we can see about the enhanced feedback cycle status report. So now we have introduced in all the report a graphical representation, so which will provide a clear status for the HR administrator to see what is the status of the particular feedback cycle. So now the HR administrator can see the status, how much completion has been done, how much completion or have not done in a particular feedback cycle status. So the HR admin can filter the status by cycle wise, department wise, location wise. So based on that, they can generate different status can be tracked in this report. And also we have additional feature we have added, which is the daily progress. So this daily progress will show how many activities has been completed on a single day. So that will give a better view for the HR to track the action items completion on a particular day, so that they can do the necessary action for completing the process as per the deadline. So this report also can be fetched in a grid view, and the data will be provided in a detailed way, and the same can be exported from the HR admin. So once the exporting is done, the data will be automatically sent to the respective user inbox. So now we can move to the next report, which is the performance rating and score report. So in this report also we have improved the chart view. It will provide a detailed information of how many employees got a rating distribution. This report mainly helps the HR to analyze the bell curve view among the employees in a particular feedback cycle, whatever we have selected now. So this report helps to see the rating and the score of the employee in a particular feedback cycle. So next we can see about the attrition report and new hire report. Similarly, in this report also we have introduced the graphical representation. So this will help the HR to analyze the attrition in the organization based on the relieving type, based on the reason for relieving, and also they can track the new hire trend in the organization with the help of this attrition report and new hire report. So in this report you can see the relieving type like involuntary, rapid, that can be tracked from this report on month-on-month basis. You can track. So it is purely based on the selection what we are doing for the generation of this report. So next we can see about the mobile app enhancement which we have recently introduced in the mobile app. So the features are new profile page. So the new profile page with basic details and reporting structure details have been enhanced, and we have added the push notification in the continuous feedback and the core value rating module. And we have the enhanced UI for the landing page and the my profile pages. And now the users can also upload their photos from the mobile app itself, and that can be added to the profile pages. So these are some of the mobile app enhancements that we have launched in the product recently. So next, we have other features which we have in the system, the bulk reset password. So this bulk reset password helps the HR administrator to do the bulk resetting of the password for a bunch of employees in a single go. So this feature is enabled by import function, where the HR can add the list of employees to whom they want to do the resetting the password, and they can do in a single go. So this will greatly help the HR admin to do this task. So next, we have the disable editing in the approve goal step. So this feature will mainly helps during the goal setting process. When the employee submits the goal to the approval with the manager, if the organization wants to restrict the goals to be edited by the primary manager or respective stakeholder, this option will restrict to edit or modify the goals submitted by the employees. So here the respective manager can only approve or reject the goals. So next, we have changing the primary manager when the cycle is on. So whenever the HR is trying to change a primary manager for an employee, when the employee is currently is in any of the review process, then the system will alert the HR stating that this employee is already covered in a cycle. So do you want to change the primary manager in profile as well as in the cycle? So now this feature enable the HR when the primary manager is going to be changed on a review cycle. So these are the some of the other features that we have implemented in the product now. So if you have any questions, please type. I will happy to help you on that.
Guys, if you have any questions, you can please type them in the chat window and we'll be happy to answer them. One person, Raj has asked, do you have any voice record? Yeah, we do have recording of this and we'll be sharing with you, Raj. Vidya, you have asked, can you please explain the import of goals again? Sure,
we can do that. So now we have the option for importing the goals. So we basically will define the goals in the organization, and the same can be imported in an Excel file. So once the template is ready, so you have to input the goals against the employee, and then you have to save the file, and we have called a review period concept. So you have to choose the respective review period, and then you have to do the validation. So during the validation, you will get the business validation can be done. So it will show the status. If it is okay, you can proceed to the third step for uploading the data. So if you need any more explanation so that we can have a separate training, you can write to a support. So based on that, we can take it forward on the goals import utility.
Sure, guys, we'll be sending the presentation to you all. And yeah, Sudeep has asked for presentation. We'll be sharing a presentation with everyone, guys. Raj has asked, in the product, instead of me typing, do you have voice recording facility for transcribing?
So we will have this in the next release, and that can be taken as a webinar in the next release. So maximum we can upload 10,000 records in a single go in any of the import facility. So now the Raj asked a question, what is the maximum number of records that can be imported using this template? So in the import template, we can maximum import 10,000 records in a single go.
Okay, guys, we'll wind up the session. And if you have any further more questions, share it with support@synergita.com, and we'll be happy to answer them. And also, we'll be sharing the recording and presentation of this webinar with you all. Thank you all for joining us. And we'll be back with another latest updates and features and with another webinar for you all. Thanks and bye-bye. Thank you, Naga.
Thank you, Mahavir.